The Math Center presents the slope of a line. We'll talk about the definition of the slope of a line, ways to think of slope, and how to compute slope. The slope of a line in a plane is a measure of its steepness. Positive slope goes up from left to right, so if you're on the left-hand side, it's like you're climbing uphill. Negative slope goes down from left to right, so if you're on the left-hand side, it's like you're skiing downhill. Zero slope is a horizontal line, so it's like you're walking along a sidewalk. And then undefined slope is a vertical line, and it just is straight up and down like a cliff drop-off. Slope is the ratio of a line's rise to its run, so m equals rise over run. For example, suppose the slope of a line is 3 over 2 and passes through the point 0, 2. Starting at 0, 2, you want to plot your point. Then we need to rise 3 and run 2. So with that, from 0, 2, we will rise 3, 1, 2, 3. And run 2, 1, 2, to get the resulting point of 2, 5. And then I can connect the two points to draw the line. If you want, you can always double check and recount to make sure you plotted correctly. We have a rise of 1, 2, 3, and a run of 1, 2. So we are correct. For slope, rise is always the difference in the y-coordinates, and run is always the difference in the x-coordinates. So for example, if point P has coordinates x1, y1, and Q has coordinates x2, y2, then slope is m equals y2 minus y1, or the difference in the y-values. Over x2 minus x1, which is the difference in the x values, or the horizontal distance. For this example, we want to find the slope of a line passing through the points negative 2, 0, and 4, 9. So since m equals y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, we are going to plug in the values we are given. With the y values, I'm going to start with 9, and then I have to subtract the other y value, which in this case is 0. Keep in mind, you can technically subtract these in any order you want. However, whatever y value you start with, you have to also start with its corresponding x value when you get to the denominator. So I would start with 4 minus the other x value, which in this case is negative 2. From there, I want to simplify my fraction. So 9 minus 0 would give me 9. And 4 minus negative 2, because we have minus a negative, that turns into just addition. And so then this is like 4 plus 2, which would give us 9 over 6. Because we can simplify 9 over 6 by dividing both numbers by 3, we can go ahead and do that. 9 divided by 3 gives us 3, and 6 divided by 3 gives us 2, so our slope is 3 over 2. For this next example, we want to find the slope of a line passing through the points 6, negative 3, and negative 5, negative 2. Since m equals y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, we will follow the same process. I'm going to start with using negative 2 first. So on the top, I would have negative 2 minus my other y value, which in this case is negative 3. Then on the denominator, we would have our x values. Since I started with negative 2, I have to then start with negative 5 in the denominator and subtract the other x value, which in this case is 6. From here, I want to simplify my fraction. Negative 2 minus negative 3 would change because minus negative 3 is actually addition, just like the last example had. So then negative 2 plus 3 would give us a positive 1 in the numerator. And then in the denominator, we have negative 5 minus 6, which would give us negative 11. So then our slope is negative 1 over 11. Keep in mind, because our slope is a negative number, that would indicate that this line would go down and to the right if we were to plot it. Thank you for watching this presentation on the slope of a line.